Hey, welcome to church today.
Welcome, everyone. We're so glad you're here.
Man, we have so much in store for you. First, we have values, then we have worship, then we got a main point, and a video we're all gonna watch together.
Hey, so let's get started with our values.
With our values.
Now, I wonder who knows value number one? Let's see. Naji! Do you know value number one?
I do, it's my favorite.
What is it?
Love God.
That's right, that's our first value. Now, do you know why we love God?
Oh, I do. I know it for sure, because God is love and he first loved us. So we love God, it's so important.
That's right, and then we have our second value, which involves God, because we're supposed to love God and then love somebody else, do you know?
My mom and dad?
Yep, that's part of it.
My brother and sister?
Yep, that's another part.
All my friends?
That's right, all people.
All people?
Yeah, so our second value is to love people.
We love people because God loves all people. It's amazing, God's so good to us.
He is. Now guys, this third value, we wanna see if you know it. So you tell us on a count of three what you think it is. One, two, three.
Do your best.
That's right. Do your best is our third value. And when we do our best,
God does the rest.
Yep, that's
right. It's awesome.
Now, Naji.
Yes.
This last one is really great because it leads into something that's also really great. Can you tell us value number four?
Ooh, I can. It's have fun.
That's right. We have fun. Do you know why?
We have fun because God gives us joy.
Yes, he gives us joy. That's a great thing.
Yeah, and we get to show that joy in worship.
Yep.
So we're gonna do worship right now. Are you guys ready?
I'm ready.
I'm ready. Let's worship.
All right, everybody, let's worship God. Let's go this way.
Breaking through the dark in my life as you shine.
You give me strength to dance.
You give me strength to dance. Back to life again. On and on, all my days, sing your praises. You give me strength to dance. So I can lift my hands. On and on, all my days, sing your praises. Holding me together.
Great job, you guys.
All right, we have another song of worship. Let's go ahead and increase that energy and let's get those legs moving. All right, we're gonna clap up and over. Here we go. Let's sing it out. You won't let go.
To Jesus with your whole heart. Sing every day.
Jesus.
sing Jesus. Jesus is mighty to save you, to work for you. He loves you so much. So let's worship God because he is love and he first loved us. Come on, sing, you are powerful. Worshiping everybody. Hi, everybody. Let's go ahead and bow our heads and close our eyes. We're going to pray. Thank you, Jesus, that you are powerful. You're in control, God, and you love us. So we don't have to worry about anything. But all we need is you, Jesus. So please be with us today. Come into our lives and be our best friend. In Jesus' name. And everyone said,
Amen.
Amen.
Hey everyone, it's time for the memory verse. So get up on your feet. This first time, I'll say it and you watch. The second time, I'll say it and you repeat after me. And the third time, we'll all say it together. If you're ready, put your thinking cap on. All right, this first time, I'll say it and you watch. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, and whatever is admirable. If anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Philippians 4:8. Okay, everyone, this time you're gonna repeat after me. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable. If anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Philippians 4:8. Great job, you guys. All right, this time we're all gonna say it together. Here we go. Finally,
Brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Philippians 4:8. Great job, you guys. Hey, keep practicing that memory verse, and we'll see you next time.
Way to go, guys, on that memory verse. Yeah. We're going to move into our next part of the service, which is our main point. So our main point for today is, even when I feel hurt, I can still love like Jesus.
Oh.
What's wrong, Najee?
That's kind of hard for me right now, Alexis.
Why?
Well, I was working on this really cool Lego statue at home.
Legos.
I was building it for hours. It looked so cool, Alexis.
That's awesome.
But then my big sister came by and she broke it. And I'm so upset about it. Like, I wish that she could feel how I feel and that she could get what she deserves. I'm so frustrated.
You know, Najee, a lot of people struggle with those same feelings. When you're hurt, it's hard to still love. But God wants our reaction to be love, not to always just feel hurt and want to get back at someone. So we're going to learn a little bit more about that today and how Jesus still loves us, even when we do things that might hurt him. So yeah. We're going to learn from Jay and Jeremy today in this video. Check it out.
There's a song coming up in my soul, Lord, in my soul. There's a song coming up in my soul, Lord, in my soul. I see the light.
What's up? What's up? What's up?
What's up?
What's up? My name's Jeremy.
That's a lot of what's ups.
Yeah, I felt it in my bones.
It's okay, though. Yeah. My name's Jay, and we're so glad you're hanging with us today.
We are. And today is going to be great, because we're going to be talking about our thought life.
You know, I thought we would be talking about our thoughts, but I thoughtfully thought that we would think about what we were doing when we talked about our thoughtful tips first.
I think you're thinking correctly. Let's do it.
All right.
Tip number one, bring your Bible to church every Sunday. We're not just going to read off the screen. We're going to be learning how to find the scriptures in our actual Bible and read the word all together.
Man, that was a thoughtful tip.
Yeah.
You really thought about that tip.
I think I did.
I think you should watch me do my tip.
Okay.
Tip number two, bring your listening ears.
Yeah, what's up? Yeah, I'm listening to you. I feel
bad. Who are you calling there, bro?
Hey, I'm doing important things.
Who are you listening to?
Yeah, I'll meet you at the White House. Right. I will be there on my private jet. Yeah, cool. Listen up.
We're going to learn a lot this series, and we don't want you to miss any of it.
That's awesome. Hey, question for you, man. Have you ever wanted to get back at someone?
Ooh.
Like, they may have done something to you where you thought you needed to get even with them or get back at them?
Not off the top of my head. I mean, wait. There was this one time when I used to race horses.
Hold on. You,
Used to race horses?
No,
horse racing.
Horse racing?
Horse races.
Jay, horse you races. You would race horses?
Gideon.
You raise Gideon, horses Gideon, or you Gideon, raced horses? Gideon. Or like, you raced... We're gonna find out.
What's Jay thinking
No! No! Jay!
What? Man, that wasn't fair. Those people need to get what they deserve today.
What are you talking about?
I think people need to get what they deserve, man. I mean, people do me wrong, and I deserve revenge. It's not fair. It's not right. I practiced so hard to ride that horse as fast as I can.
Horse? What horse are you talking about? Either way. That's not the best way to think, dude.
And why not, bro? I mean, I was hurt. I should be able to hurt them back, right?
Hey, you're 10. Let's bring it back down to a 4. Breathe.
Let's lower it from a race to a trot.
Okay.
Okay.
I get why you would want to think that, but that's not a Christ-like way to look at it, man. Mm. The world around us tells us that revenge is the proper way to handle things, but Jesus shows us the right way in his word. Let's look at it, and you should too. Grab your Bible and turn to Romans 12, 14 through 21. We're going to talk about it and be back shortly.
That's good. Man, that passage we just talked about was pretty straightforward about, you know, striving to do good for others. I can get so caught up in my own thoughts about what I believe should be done, but I need to match my thoughts with God's thoughts.
Dude, that's awesome. You've already learned so much. See, the world tells us that we need to get back at people or get even. But God clearly tells us so many times in the Bible that that's not the answer. We read one example, but another one could be found in Leviticus 19, 18. Jay, you want to read it for us today?
Sure, bro.
All right,
Leviticus 19, 18. Do not seek revenge or bear a grudge against anyone among your people, but love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord. You know, that verse is really clear that we should always love people and never pay back evil for evil. We need to be obedient to God and do what Jesus would do in that moment.
That's right. And that's why our main point is even when I feel hurt, I can still love like Jesus. You see, God is love, and he wants us to always show love to people, no matter the circumstance.
Yeah, man, but that can be really tough.
I'm not gonna lie. It can be really hard. But I actually wanted to show you a great example of this in the Bible with King David. He was faced with a situation where it probably would have been easier to be mad and repay evil with evil. But instead, he chose to do what is right, and he showed love. Let's check it out.
The story begins in the land of Israel as we look into the life of David. David was a shepherd boy, and although he was the youngest of four sons in his family, he was chosen by God to be the next king of Israel. But David had to wait a very long time until that promise would come true. And in the meantime, he was watching over his sheep and goats. He had to be patient because at that time there was another king on the throne of Israel. His name was Saul. Saul was strong and tall and looked like everything a king should be. But God doesn't look at our outward appearance. Instead, he focuses on our hearts. And ultimately, Saul was disobedient and did not follow God like he was supposed to. And for that reason, God chose to take the kingdom from his family and give it to David. After some time, David was sent to Saul to serve him. Saul loved him so much, and David was appointed his armor bearer. David became a great warrior, and after defeating Goliath the giant, Saul named him the commander of his armies, and David became successful in everything he did. Everyone in the kingdom loved David. But this started to make Saul jealous and angry at David because he was afraid of him and thought he would try to kill him and take the throne away from his family. So Saul wanted to kill David, but the Lord was with David and he kept him safe. David fled and escaped to multiple places after he was warned about King Saul's intentions. Saul kept trying to find ways to get rid of David and he hunted him, but Saul wasn't able to catch him. Day after day, Saul searched for him, but God did not give David into his hands. Moving from place to place, about 600 men started following David wherever he went. One day, Saul was told that David was in the desert of En-Gedi. So Saul chose 3,000 elite soldiers, the best he could find in all Israel, and set out in search of David near the region of the Wild Goat Rocks. During Saul's search for David, he went into the cave to take a break. Well, this very cave was the one where David and his men were hiding. And when David's men saw that Saul was unaware that David was there and unable to defend himself, they whispered, "Now's your opportunity. Today the Lord is telling you, I will certainly put your enemy into your power to do with as you wish." So David crept forward and cut off a piece of Saul's robe. Immediately, he felt guilty, and David began to think that it was not right for him to harm Saul's life, even after all the trouble and all the hardship he has caused him. It was so easy for David to put an end to all of this, but he realized that no matter what Saul has done, it was still not right for him to hurt the one who God had chosen as king over Israel. So David ordered his men to step away, and he did not let them harm King Saul. Saul got up, left the cave, and went down to the road. David came out and shouted after Saul, "My lord, the king!" When Saul looked behind him, he saw that David bowed down with his face to the ground. "Why do you listen to the people who say I'm trying to harm you? This very day, you can see with your own eyes this isn't true. Some of my men told me to kill you, but I spared you. I cut off a piece of your robe, but I didn't kill you. This proves that I am not trying to harm you and that I have not sinned against you, even though you've been hunting for me to kill me." Then David went on to promise that he would never harm Saul. David said that God would be the one to protect David and to rescue him from Saul's power. Saul said, "Is that really you, my son David?" And he began to cry. And he said to David, "You are a better man than I am, for you have repaid me good for evil. Yes, you have been amazingly kind to me, for when the Lord put me in a place where you could have killed me, you didn't do it. Who else would let his enemies get away when he had him in his power? May the Lord reward you for the kindness you have shown me today. And now I realize that you are surely going to be king and that the kingdom of Israel will flourish under your rule. Now swear to me by the Lord that when that happens, you will not kill my family." So David promised that he would not hurt Saul's family, and they left each other in peace. Now Saul continued to cause difficulty in David's life, but David kept his promise, and in time, David did become king of Israel. David was dearly loved by God, and Israel did flourish under his rule, because David did everything that God wanted him to do, and he was a man after God's own heart.
So, what'd you think?
Man, that story was kind of wild. David was like a hero. I mean, he killed Goliath. Mm-hmm. It was so crazy how his mentor, King Saul, got so jealous of David's popularity that he tried to kill him himself. And it's even crazier how David actually had the chance to get revenge on Saul many times and pay him back for all the pain he had caused him. Yet, he chose not to. It was such a great story.
It is such a great story, man. So the best part is the result to David's action. Saul knew that David could have easily killed him in the cave, but he chose not to. It completely changed the way Saul looked at David. And that's the way God calls each of us to be in the world. Mm. The Bible tells us to be light in the darkness. And that is exactly what David did. He showed love and mercy to Saul at a time when it was really not easy to. I mean, the guy was searching to kill him.
You know, man, this reminds me of the story of Jesus you've told me so many times.
Really? Why do you say that?
If I remember this correctly, Jesus came to the world to save the world. But while he was here, a lot of people were not very nice to him. Even as, like, he was carrying the cross to die for each one of our sins, the people there were mocking and spitting at him. through all of that, he still went through with God's plan and died on the cross for every one of us and all of our sins, including the people that were doing all those bad things to him. That was the ultimate display of love.
Bro, that is so cool. Because that's it. Like, Jesus gave us a great example of how not to respond with revenge, but with love instead. What is awesome is that same Jesus that responded that way loves us so much, even though we can be pretty bad sometimes. Mm. But he still wants to be our best friend. He wants you to accept his love. He wants you and I to follow him and become more and more like him. It is the best, the greatest thing we could ever do. I mean, to believe him, turn from our old behaviors, and become more and more like Jesus.
That's so awesome, man. I feel great knowing that when revenge or any evil thought creeps up into my mind, I know that God wants me to respond with love. Man, it's been so great learning with you today.
Yeah.
And don't forget, our main point for the day is even when I feel hurt, I can still love like Jesus.
It has been a good day. And it's been a great day with you too. So signing off, we'll see you real soon. Real soon.
Wow, what a great video. I learned a lot during that video.
Yeah, I did too. I know it's gonna be hard, but Jesus asked me to show love to people. And I love my sister. I don't wanna be mean to her. So I'm gonna do my best and I'm gonna respond in love, even though she hurt my feelings.
Yeah, well, remember the story of David and Saul.
I do.
Yeah, Saul was in the cave and David had his moment to get back at Saul. But even though he was hurting, he chose to respond with love and not hurt him and honor him. That is really hard.
It was really hard, but I wanna be like David. David was so cool.
Yeah.
Well, we had such a great time learning with you guys. After this video, there's gonna be a prayer card on the screen, and we really want you to pray this with your family and whoever's around you, because we need God's help to love people even when we're hurt.
Yeah, that's right. And also, we want to give you guys an opportunity to ask Jesus into your heart.
So
maybe
important.
You've never done that before. Well, today can be your day. So be sure to pray that prayer today. And if you do, make sure you tell your parents. We're so glad that you joined us today, and we cannot wait to see you next time. Bye, guys.
Bye.